No, oh, you just went.
Now we are live, boys.
Oh,
oh yeah, stretch out, stretch out, get loose for the cast, you know. Oh, so how is everyone tonight?
Doing good.
Going potty.
Well, yeah, you know, that's a good way to start the podcast. How is everyone tonight? I'm going potty.
I mean, that's good, though.
I mean...
That's healthy.
Hey, it's better out than in, I always say. I guess.
Yeah. Sigh.
What's going on, Black Rex, Keyblades, and Arky? How's it going, guys? I'm not sure it's a contest, but Justin wins. Yeah.
This would be the beard nest.
Yeah, it would. You can't even see the whole thing because of the way that the window, like, crops him out. But, yeah. His beard wins. For sure.
Here's your water.
You need in potty.
No. Bad dog.
Uh-oh.
You talking to your daughter?
I thought... No, he's talking to the dog. I hope.
My cracker. Mine.
I think he's talking to the dog. I hope he's talking to the dog.
He'll be with us shortly.
Yeah, Ian will be with us shortly. So where do we want to start, Justin?
Let's start from the top.
Well, we're going to start with a topic that Ian actually brought up last week, and I thought it was a pretty good topic then, but I kind of had some second thoughts about it, and I thought a little bit more about it. And Ian talked about, we talked a little bit about, mobile gaming versus console gaming. And I'm not sure that was the greatest comparison. We did talk about it, but I'm thinking more mobile gaming versus handheld gaming.
Yeah, that's a much more, like, equal playing field.
Yeah, it's more of a parallel. So, I don't know what mobile games you play a lot, Justin. So, I'm...
I've got a handful that I play. I never really was into them until I got this newest phone. I got the, Nexus 6 or something.
Mm-hmm.
But, I've been playing that Star Wars game that everyone plays, Galaxy of Heroes or whatever on there. That's a fun little time waster.
I guess I'm the one guy who doesn't play this game, apparently.
Yeah. I mean, there's really not a lot of gameplay to it. It's more just like a grind game, but it's kind of fun getting the different characters and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And there's kind of multiplayer components as well, which, like, as you know, that's always what I'm drawn to is multiplayer shit. Ian and Cody and Luke, like, that's all they do. We try to play D&D, and they're sitting there on their phones, like, guys, you need to make perception checks.
You need to make a perception check. Stop trying to kill that stormtrooper!
Yeah. There's a really cool one that I got, though. I actually bought, it's called Reigns,
mm-hmm.
and it's a Devolver Digital title. And it's really simple. It's like a swipe left, swipe right game where you just make choices as, like, a king. And it just has, like, all these, like, absurd outcomes. And the art kind of drew me to it. It's kind of a really stylized, like, simplistic kind of art style to it.
Okay.
Yeah. It's pretty fun, though. There's a dog who is the devil.
See, I guess I'm a little different because I don't play a lot of mobile games. Like, most of the mobile games I play is I just installed emulators and I'm playing Game Boy Classic games on my phone.
Classic.
Like, I'm mostly playing Pokemon Blue on my phone. So, hi, Cody! By the way, guys, Norse Warrior in chat is the fourth member of our staff.
The fourth horseman.
He will be a host at some point when he gets back to America from Kuwait. So, there's that. He had some thoughts on this, but we're not going to talk about them because he's not here.
That's right.
Cody.
He should be in bed. Go to bed.
He can talk about it in chat. Yeah, he should be in bed. You should be in bed, dude. It's like fucking 6 in the morning. You work in like 8 hours. Whoa, that is an angry child. You know what I kind of think mobile games are going to wind up? I think eventually we're going to see less of, like, the Candy Crushes, and there's some really cool mobile games too, don't get me wrong, but I think the more we go on, we're going to start getting, like, handheld platformers. Not, like, running games, but, like, with virtual buttons and stuff. I think that's eventually going to happen. Although, I've thought that for a long time, because it's not like that's a new capability for phones.
Right, the virtual buttons thing is tricky because they suck.
Right, that's true. There's also...
That's definitely something that handheld consoles have over that.
There's also... I mean, you can buy, like, a controller. Like, there's one... I see it at Target all the time. I always think about buying it, but I actually think the phone's too big for it. that you can, it's got like a little holder for the screen, and you just plug it in via the mini USB, and it just a little, it looks like an Xbox controller that holds your phone, and it lets you use that for the buttons for games and such. I feel like that would be really cool, but I feel, also feel like it would be, whoa.
My, like it would mute you.
Yeah, my audio just cut out for a second. Did that last night too. I don't know what that's all about. Maybe my audio drivers need updating again.
Maybe you just talk too much, Tim.
Yeah, maybe.
This talk show was a bad idea.
It was a terrible idea. Wouldn't that make it the perfect idea? No. Because
no.
No. Fair. Well, we wanted to get Ian's thoughts on this.
I know, Ian. What are you doing?
He's probably changing a diaper. Bella does not sound happy.
No.
No.
Last
thing we heard from Ian was that's my cracker.
It was my cracker.
Oh, you're back, Ian. We're talking about mobile gaming.
Oh.
Versus handheld gaming.
Is the worst.
What's the worst? Yes. No, what is? I didn't hear you. Potty training is the worst. I'll be going through that dream in a few months. So.
Oh.
I'll be asking you for tips.
Times. I gotta go potty. We went potty. Didn't go. Come back to the room. Gotta go potty. Went. Didn't go. 10 times, Tim.
10 times. Not one. Not two.
I love handheld gaming. However, I have my phone with me more than I have handheld gaming.
That's fair.
If mobile gaming can get up to the graphic speed as handheld, I mean, why wouldn't it surpass it?
I feel like it can.
Yeah.
But like Justin said, the inputs for handheld kind of take the cake there.
You ain't got no buttons.
I almost wonder if you're going to start seeing phones with like down the road, right. You're going to see phones that look like more like a handheld device.
Well, I've played some games that have like touchscreen buttons.
See that? Yeah, that's what we're talking about. That's
they suck.
They're not as
You darn swallow beard.
Did you just call him a swallow beard?
Yes, Tim, I did, okay? You little mandrake.
Okay, you called me a little mandrake, but what was the noise after that? Because it sounded like a bear.
That was a little mandrake.
I legit... That's
the same thing before you attack, you little mandrake.
I sound like a bear before I attack?
Yeah.
Is that why no one watches me play video games? Because I'm just constantly going and attacking?
It's that hotline bling.
It's that hotline bling.
Yeah.
I think another thing about, like, the 3DS has things that you'll never see on a phone, like Pokemon. Although, I mean, now we got Pokemon Go, so that's going to start blurring the lines, maybe.
I play Pokemon Blue on my phone more than anything else. I was just playing it earlier.
Well, okay, but, I mean, modern Hacks. Pokemon game. You can't trade with people, you can't play online.
Well, see, I feel like that wouldn't be that hard to design a game, like, a game for phones where you could do that.
Yeah, I don't think it would be hard, but I feel like Nintendo really needs to keep their titles on their systems, otherwise their systems won't sell.
Well, like, at what point does handheld gaming stop?
Never.
You know, Nintendo is going to keep coming up with, like, the next Game Boy, or are they eventually just going to be like, we're done?
Right.
It'll probably be determined by sales, as long as it's selling well, I mean.
Right.
Yeah, I've wondered that about the Nintendo Switch now. Like, if you're going to be able to just go around with it, is that going to end up negatively impacting, like, the 3DS sales?
Well, it's like, because I got the PSP when that came out. I didn't like it. I'd rather, you know, sit at home and play the PS2.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Don't get me wrong. I'm
so foamy.
Every now and then. Like, last Christmas, I got Crystal the 3DS. And then I bought myself Pokemon, and I played that. Better believe that.
Better believe that!
Mm-hmm. Now I haven't picked up Sun or Moon yet, because I'm torn. I don't know which one to pick.
The last time I bought a mobile or a handheld game was... I didn't even own the handheld
the
I was playing. What?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's always praising the sun. He's a sun bro.
When he praises.
So, like, I was playing my sister's DS. I bought a game and I was using her DS. I haven't had my own. since Game Boy Advance. So what was that like?
I've gotten a lot of play out of my 3DS. Like, I just like a lot of titles that are on there, and like, I get a ride to work, to and from work, every day, so it's like I got a lot of downtime.
That's fair.
Yeah, I used to play the DS on my overnights when I worked them.
Yeah.
And when my wife was in labor with our daughter here.
You were just in the hospital playing the Nintendo, playing on your DS?
Well, I mean, not when she was giving birth.
Just straight up, push, baby. Hang on.
Her pushing. Sorry.
I was pushing the buttons. I'm sorry.
Oh, not that.
Oh, not that. Oh, God.
Aw, Cody wanted to make an appearance.
What?
Cody said that we sound really quiet, me and Ian.
You?
Isn't he the Norse warrior?
He's Norse warrior. Where did he say?
I love you, Cody!
Oh. Yeah, he wanted to make appearances and come say hi in chat, though. That's what he was saying.
Yeah.
I know, I forgot to put chat on, and now I just went to
chat.
And I was,
okay.
Sorry for late to the party, I was potty training myself.
Well,
my daughter.
I was potty training myself! If you two were quiet, it should be better now. I slid the slider up a bit. So.
Good.
Hopefully.
Can you hear us now, Cody? I don't care, go to bed.
Yeah, Cody.
I guarantee you.
Yeah, he's just laying in bed watching on his...
Yeah, he...
Turn your volume up, Cody.
Sleep.
My stuff keeps, like, cutting out. I don't...
Your little box keeps popping up, Tim. I keep seeing your box, you
what
whore.
Box?
That box away.
What box? What are you talking
about? The box, Tim. The box. I keep seeing it. Put it away.
What box?
Yeah. What's in the box? I don't know. The little
know
Skype box.
What are you even talking
sword.
About right now? What
your
sword?
In the box, Tim.
What are you? What are you talking about?
Keep saying it.
Oh, are you talking? Are you talking about the Skype box that changes
yeah.
the? That's because it should be cycling
listen.
Between me and Justin.
I keep minimizing it, and it keeps coming up so I can see your sword box. I don't want to see your sword box.
It's not my fault.
It's your fault.
It is. Cody
I don't know why. Yeah, I don't know why Cody's typing in the Facebook chat and not in the Twitch chat. Because
he doesn't want
like,
to ruin your Twitch
you
chat.
On a TV.
Observation. You sound quiet.
Yeah, Cody. What's up, Shane? What up, Farmer Green 13? What up, dude?
Farmer, you know what?
Yeah.
Shane burnt out on Overwatch.
I
hey, remember that one time when Shane was gonna fill in for Justin,
and I played 15 minutes of intro music instead.
Yeah, because Shane decided to be a little bitch.
Pepperidge Farms remembers.
Pepperidge Farms.
Long it's
memory.
Shane to you.
No.
Well. Okay, then.
Cody can't reach the keyboard.
Fucking Siege, bro. That's right.
Is he still typing in Facebook? I'm not looking at Facebook.
No shirts. Sure, Scimitars. Arena.
Jim, get your sword box. Oh, hi, Justin.
The sword box is going to pop up again because we got to... We have to move on, Ian. All right.
Yeah, let's move on.
We've been talking...
Next topic.
Yeah, next topic. So, Mass Effect Andromeda is what we're talking about.
Yes.
So
I played all the games.
You
love them.
You are lying out of your face hole.
Hey, in all honesty though, like, cause Cody used to be a roommate of mine once upon a time. I don't know if you knew that or not.
Yeah.
And he kept telling me how amazing they were, and I've literally had all three of them on my Amazon wish list. So if you guys want to buy them, feel free. And but I just haven't got a chance
free
to sit
right
down
now.
Play them.
Well, you need to play them right now. Well, I guess you. Have consoles and not a PC anyway, but right now, for those who haven't played it and want to play a Mass Effect game before Andromeda releases, Origin has Mass Effect 2 for free right now. I learned that from my good friend Ben. So,
aww, that's a title movie I'm writing.
I know, but you still are writing it 8 years later, 9 years, 10 years later. Oh, Jesus, I sat on the mute button. My good friend Ben, I sat on a mute button. I'm sorry, I muted you guys for a second. Well,
how do you sit on the mute button?
Because it's on this!
Dude, on
is
top
everything
of your
just computer? Taped to your chair?
It's right here!
I don't know
so
what
it...
you're pointing at.
You can
your
see
forehead
my screen!
Is on your forehead?
You can see my I'm not pointing!
Oh.
It's on that!
Your forehead when you said it's right here, so I thought you might. It was on your forehead. Hey, guys, I want to hear your opinions on the new Mass Effect. The trailer looks freaking awesome, by the way.
Well, yeah, and it looks like we're going to actually get to drive a Mako around for the first time in a long time, so that'll be fun.
New crazy shitty vehicle to drive around.
Hey, it's an old crazy shitty vehicle from the first game. Okay.
I remember the first time I drove the Mako, like, I was just cruising around, and I was trying to, like, climb up, like, the biggest mountain I could. And so I was, like, going up, and then I was like, oh, yeah, I have a booster, so I press it, and of course the booster is from the bottom of the vehicle, so I just, like, fell off the fucking mountain.
I've done that, too.
So dumb.
Dude, the Mako is so fun. Like, Ian, are you dying over there?
Dead.
He's gonna die before he ever plays a Mass Effect game, apparently. But yeah. I think it's interesting that the new one's not gonna like. I understand. Obviously, it's not gonna be about Shepard because you know, based on which ending is canon, which we don't know. I don't even think it matters which ending is canon because it's in a brand new galaxy.
Yeah, like the what are they called? What's your group called in the new one?
I don't even know what the group is called in the new one. I just know that you're the Pathfinder now.
Oh, right. Yeah, that's what I was thinking of.
Yeah, you're the Pathfinder, not the Shepherd.
Yeah, your whole ship is just shot off into deep space, middle of nowhere, to find new, like, places to colonize.
Yeah.
And they're, like, new alien species you come across and shit, and you have no idea what's happening back in, like, your known space.
You know, I'm wondering, are you going to be forced to play as a human again? Because the first three games, and that's, like, really?
Yep. I'm pretty sure. I was reading about it in Game Informer. Pretty sure you're the son or daughter of a human Pathfinder.
Oh, okay. I was hoping there would just be a
You just muted yourself, bro.
No, I didn't, though. I don't know why. It's my audio drivers keep cutting out. Like, this doesn't control that mic. There's something else, because when it happened, my headset, like, I couldn't hear anything either. Something's fucky with my system right now, apparently, which is it's okay, but it's concerning.
Everyone just wants to hear me anyway.
That's right.
I would love to have a Mass Effect single player campaign story where you could actually choose the race of your character, because I feel like that would have so much replayability going through as the different races.
Yeah.
Like a Destiny?
Like a what?
Like a Destiny.
Nah, not really. I feel like in Destiny, it doesn't really matter what you pick.
No. I just meant like the different races and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Kind of like that, but like way more.
Yeah, the only time we've really gotten that at all so far is in Mass Effect 3 multiplayer, which was a lot of fun, but...
Dude, Mass Effect 3 multiplayer was amazing.
I still play it sometimes. It's so fun.
Dude, I would pick that up if it was, like, sold on its own right now, this instant.
Oh, I can see that.
Because I loved it.
Yeah, I wonder if... I think Andromeda's going to have some of that co-op multiplayer.
It sounds like, in that Game Informer article, it talked about how they saw how successful Mass Effect 3's multiplayer was, and they want to recreate that, in a sense, for this one. And they also want it to kind of feel... like, they don't want it to feel so separate from the single-player campaign. Like, they want them to basically play the same, so you can just jump into one or the other without being, like, disoriented, I guess.
So, I'm...
Cody said, like, Skyrim, but I don't know what he's referring to.
He's talking about the character customization. So, like, in Skyrim, you can be whatever you want, and it affects the gameplay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I guess that's kind of what I want in terms of a character customization for Mass Effect. I think that would be pretty cool.
Yeah, different racial traits, different reactions from NPCs and stuff.
Yeah, I think that would be pretty awesome.
Because that's one of the biggest things in Mass Effect, is like the different species of aliens all have such different societies and like react to each other very differently.
Right, and I think that would be really cool, especially on a game that's so choice-driven. Like throughout the Mass Effect series, you know, it's been so choice-driven that I feel like that much more option and replayability. You could play through as every race and it would affect your game. It's a lot of work, obviously, for BioWare to do that, but it also would be pretty badass, I think.
Yeah, I think it'd be amazing. Because they really created a great IP that they can just expand upon a shit ton. Luckily, they figured out how to do that after 3. That would have been a really sad dead end for the series.
Oh, yeah, it would have. You know, speaking of dead end IPs and BioWare, this is not... I actually didn't write this at all in the thing, so this is going to be a little more... thing. Did you ever play Knights of the Old Republic?
Me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So...
Oh, yeah.
So Knights of the Old Republic was obviously... I mean, BioWare kind of... It's kind of where they started.
Yeah. Right?
Like, they did that before Mass Effect, and it kind of was a launching point for them. And it just so happens that EA currently... You have to go through EA to make any Star Wars any game Star right Wars. Now because Disney signed the rights for games to EA. Do we think... Hey, what's up, Keegan? Do we think it's possible that we might get a new KOTR game?
Possible? I mean...
Naughty Dog's doing a Star Wars game that looks amazing, by the way. But
yeah,
like...
excited for that. BioWare doing another Star Wars title? I mean, they've got The Old Republic kicking around, and people said that they really like what's been done with, like, the newest update for that. But I really have no interest in that game, so I'd love a proper return to the Knights of the Old Republic series from them.
Yeah, like...
Whether it's in the cards, I don't know.
I mean, the MMO was cool and all. I mean, it was fun. I didn't play very much of it. I played a little bit of it, but, like, when it first went free-to-play, I played some of it. I don't even... No. Keegan says, Respawn Entertainment, the guys who made Titanfall, they're doing a new Star Wars game as well.
Now that is super promising because Titanfall is dope.
I
love that game.
I wonder if that's going to be, if they're taking, I don't think they would, but Titanfall, as cool as it is just, you know, it's another, other than it has mechs, it's a standard FPS. Other than it has mechs, it's a standard FPS for today, right? So I almost wonder if they're doing another, because I believe Respawn, that's the group that broke away. That was the original Call of Duty guys, right?
And then, something like that, yeah.
Because like they broke off of Treyarch or whatever to do Titanfall. I wonder if they're doing the new Battlefront, if it's going to be taken away from...
Dude, I would love that.
Yeah.
I feel like that would be excellent.
I feel like they would do with the free-running system that is badass as hell in Titanfall.
in Battlefront.
Yeah, right? Like, that would be so freaking cool.
Yeah.
Keegan says, I am right. Like, that's the original Call of Duty guys.
Yeah.
So,
nice.
I think that would be a freaking amazing one.
Yeah, I think that a lot of people were disappointed with the way DICE ended up doing Battlefront. I know I was. Like, it was very pretty, but the gameplay was just not there. I was really expecting, like, a return to the old Battlefront games. And it was just, like, not that in any way.
I mean, it was fun, but it was Battlefield Star Wars.
Yeah.
Like, that's all it felt like. It was a fun game, but it was just Battlefield Star Wars. I mean, they didn't even try and hide it. They just, you know, it was the same. Looking at the menu, it's Battlefront menu. It's Battlefront text. Like, everything's Battlefront, just Star Wars. And it was very cool, but it... was different.
It lacked a lot of staying power for me. Like, I played Aliens quite a bit. Side note.
Yeah. So, Crystal, you know, works at a bar.
Right.
And it was this girl's 21st birthday. She was there with her parents, and her parents were like, it's your 21st birthday. It's time to take 21 shots.
Oh, dear God. Somebody
like,
better
parents,
call that woman.
Why would you do that?
No.
She was on her ninth. Okay. She was on her ninth shot before she was done.
Jesus.
Yeah,
bad parenting.
Keegan, I think that's a really good way to sum it up. Like Keyblade said, the game wasn't bad, but the game just doesn't really have... It's not the same as the old Battlefront games. It doesn't have that same soul. It doesn't feel quite right for the IP.
It's hard to put words on what it is, but I mean, there are a lot of aspects of it that were really good. Like you mentioned, all the heroes, they all kind of add their own flair. They had that Galactic Conquest or whatever.
Yeah.
I loved like playing Galactic Conquest with a friend and like taking over planets one by one, choosing your upgrade path.
That's
like
so
that
fun.
Was super fun.
Or even just like I mean, I was kind of hoping that it would have an expansive campaign, kind of like the Battlefield games did, and it didn't. So I thought if DICE was going to do it, give me an awesome campaign, and that never really came to fruition.
Yeah, yeah, it was a pity.
Yeah, like, the games were so different from what I think I, in my head, the second I heard there was a new Battlefront, I was like, hype! And
right, they should have called it something else.
Yeah, it was fun, but it just... I'm hoping that, I'm almost hoping they give it to somebody else. And Respawn, I think, would make a pretty badass Battlefront game, I would think. Not that exactly what they're doing, but...
One other thing I really didn't like about the new Battlefront was the standard linear progression for, like, your loadouts, pretty much. I mean, you can kind of pick and choose, but there was still, like, you had to go and get what you wanted.
Yeah. You had to grind.
Whereas in the old Battlefronts, you know, you just had your gun... And then, like, eventually you would, like, prestige out, and that was really cool, because then you permanently could have that.
Yeah, and in the old Battlefronts, it was the core mechanics of the gameplay, the running and shooting and stuff, was simpler than the new Battlefront game. But then they had the heroes, and they had, you know, it just felt more... It had other things that made it more expansive at the same time. So it was, like, simultaneously simpler and bigger. I don't know.
Yeah,
it's weird.
Yeah.
Combination.
Yeah, different vibes.
Yeah. I don't know why I thought of all that now, but I was like, hey, we should talk about that.
Republic Commando remake, Cody? That would be interesting. That was a pretty sweet game. The whole Republic Commando kind of series. I don't know if you read the books by Karen Travis, but she made the best Star Wars books, in my opinion.
The game
all about
was
Mandalorians
pretty tight.
And everything. Yeah.
I just replayed the game last year. It was pretty fun.
Yeah, I picked it up on Steam because I don't have my Xbox anymore, and it's fucking great.
Yeah, it's a good game. Justin, you're the perfect person to ask about this. So I think will appreciate it too.
Okay.
So Overwatch, there's a certain celebrity who is trying to get himself into the game.
Yes.
And that would be one Terry Crews.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
What do
He's
we think?
He's so great. He's so great. Ever since that Battlefield 1 event, where he was just like, yo, give me a mouse and a keyboard. I'm for real about this. And
he's on Twitch now. I don't remember what his I think it's the Terry Crews, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, he's very active on social media.
Honestly, they should just make him a character for a while.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of people say that. Yeah.
But, like, I'm not sure exactly what he... Like, I know he wants to be in the game. Do we think like Ian said, it would be funny as hell if they made him just like a character and threw him into the game and gave him his own powers and his own, you know, everything, his own abilities,
I mean,
his own weapon. But I think they're probably going to just have him voice somebody if he's that
just
wanting to be in
it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
there's this character Doomfist that's theorized to be voiced by him,
especially because he just punches everything.
Yeah, exactly. Like on one of the maps, your goal is to like escort this payload,
as
and inside
the
is this huge arm. Yeah, the Doomfist. So that would be really fun to like see that change. I was thinking about like for each new character, they usually have like some kind of event. So I was imagining they'd like have that map, and then like once you got that to a point, like one of your players would play as him or something.
That'd be so fun.
Like, I've already got all these ideas for, like, how the character would work.
It'd be like almost like a King of the Hill thing.
Yeah. I feel like Terry Crews would be like his Old Spice commercials.
Yeah, that's actually what I thought, too.
Yeah, like Cody said, flexing his chest and applying Old Spice should be his powers.
Perfect. Yeah, Keegan mentioned that his PC build video, that was
so
really
good.
Cool. He built... gaming PC to kind of connect with his son more, and he reached out to like social media to get advice on like what good parts were. He was just like, he's getting really involved in the gaming scene, and I think that's really cool.
Oh, I think our buddy Luke
like wrote down all the brands and stuff that he bought so he could price out Terry Crews's system.
Okay,
yeah.
It's probably has he come up with a number?
It was high end stuff.
I can't remember the number he said, but it was pretty ridiculous.
It's probably over $3,000.
Yeah. It was at least a couple grand.
Dude, if I could spend $3,000 on a computer, oh my god, I would be so happy.
If you like the stream, donate today.
Yes.
That's not
Redbeard needs a computer. Let's do it.
Yeah, Ian needs a computer. Yeah, that's for sure.
I can finally get on that PC game life.
That'd be nice.
Cody's on that life, but he doesn't have a goddamn desk.
Does he have a Steam account?
Yeah, we got him hooked up with a Steam account.
I'm gonna assume it's Cody BF.
No, dude, Metal Pop Tart.
It's Metal Pop Tart. Well, his old thing was always Cody BF, so.
I know.
Well, no. Well, I will give you that, but it was always between the two. It was either Cody BF or Metal Pop Tart.
Yeah, was his fair. Xbox Live name.
I feel like his Xbox.
No, it was Cody BF.
Yeah, Cody BF was Xbox Live.
Jess.
Wild. Twitch nips.
Yeah, yeah. Right?
Oh my god, I thought you said Twitch nips.
Yeah, Twitch nips. Just, Twitch nips. What is Twitch nips, Ian? I would like Twitch you to nips. Explain this to us. Is that when your nipples just start twitching?
It's when your nipples are in the shape of the T of Twitch.
Of the Twitch logo.
Yeah, the Twitch nips.
That's you that.
Ever get those?
No.
You're like, you're gaming so hard that your nipples just turn into a T.
I can't say I've gotten there.
Twitch nips.
I've never had that.
No, haven't had that happen.
I guess I need to stream more.
Yeah, right?
Or not.
You ain't live until you had them Twitch nips, son.
You know what surprised me, guys, that I didn't know until today?
What's up?
The new Kingdom Hearts game is coming this month. This month.
Well, yeah, wasn't that 2.8 or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another weird kind of
I'm still waiting for 3.
Right, yeah, it's not 3, it's 2.8. Like, I know that it's the first two games are releasing with it in, like, full...
Again.
Like, fully remastered or whatever, but then there's a new game, too, and it's 2.8?
Yeah.
I'm confused by all this. What do
I'm
you
gonna
guys
be honest,
think?
I've never played the Kingdom Hearts games, but I've always been fascinated by them. I know my wife loves them.
I swear to God, we played it at your house.
Nope, not me.
Yeah, Keyblade definitely is a fan.
Yeah, I can see that for damn sure.
I never played them myself. I tried, the HD remake of the first one.
If you can't
and I just couldn't
game.
Really get into it. It seemed alright, but just didn't really dig it.
Yeah.
But I have a lot of friends who were like super into it when it first came out on PS2 or whatever.
Oh, I lied. I did play it once.
Played that
yeah, we played it. Kiefer brought it
no,
over.
No, no,
we played
I didn't
it.
Play it with you.
Yeah, we played it at your birthday.
No, no.
I'm telling you. No, you I've didn't own it. You did not own it. We had it was one of your birthday parties. It was the same one. I remember this birthday because all we did is play video games. I feel like Justin was there too. Kiefer brought it. Like, we played. Yeah, we played We played Capcom versus Marvel. We played. Yeah, we
no
played.
Final Fantasy characters. That's
we played Kingdom Hearts because Kiefer brought it over. And then we didn't play it for very long because somebody thought. I don't remember who. Somebody thought it was dumb. And you're like, well, let's just do something else. And then we played fucking. Devil May Cry.
Ah, DMC.
Yeah, I remember this birthday. I think it was in like 8th grade or something.
You remember lies, Tim.
I remember lies and deception, but I'm pretty sure I remember this though too.
Prove it.
See, there goes my audio drivers again. What the fuck?
Yeah, so Kingdom weird. Hearts, I know it was like they had a bunch of weird games on handhelds as well, which were like plot heavy and like you had to play them to understand the other ones, so you had to like jump between a lot of systems between all the games.
That kind of that sounds a lot like Final Fantasy.
Well, Final Fantasy, like each one's its own thing,
right?
But pretty sure Kingdom Hearts is like one continuous plot.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
My audio just go out again? Okay, no, it just got quiet.
Fine.
We're good this time. Speaking of other games that are coming out this month, I think Ian will be excited about this one. I didn't know that it was coming. Oh, I knew it was coming this month, but I didn't know much about it till I actually looked into it a little bit today. New Resident Evil game.
As long as it goes back to its roots, man, in which by the trailer looks fantastic.
It looks terrifying, and I love it.
Scary.
That trailer is great. Have you guys heard the demo?
I have not.
My heart beat more. Than in like the first games where you went to open the door and the screen went pitch black and it focused on the door and it did the creak sound. And you're like, oh my god, what is behind this door? What's gonna come out at me?
Yeah, right.
It's like playing what was that old board game we played?
HeroQuest.
HeroQuest.
Oh, okay.
You open the door. Do you look in it? Nah.
Yes.
Hi, Joda.
Sorry, I didn't mean to say Joda's comment out loud. I just saw it all caps and bold there. I needed to scream.
I literally.
If you guys want
notice.
Ian to say anything, just type in all caps.
That's right. If
diplomacy!
You want, if you type anything in all caps, Ian will say it.
That's to cancel.
That's how he got fired. It's how he got fired from his job as an anchor in San Diego.
Oh, true.
Yeah, true.
That's intense.
That is. It's pretty intense. True story, too. Mm-hmm. Go fuck yourself, San Diego.
Then all caps, though, so you go, fuck yourself, San Diego! Bulbasaur!
Oh.
Yeah, new Resident Evil. It looks pretty sweet. The trailer definitely reminds me of, like, how PT was shaping up.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I can see that.
Yeah. It looks like it's going to be, yeah, first person, which
Why
is my favorite perspective.
Why do you allow these peasants to use caps when I had to petition for my rights?
Jesus.
Bullshit.
That bot's not here tonight. So, caps, as long as it's not too bad, Nightbot won't slap you. Nightbot will slap a bitch if you type a long thing in all caps. But Voluminati bot keeps the pimp hand strong. Right?
I'm better than you are, a long thing.
God damn it.
These nuts.
Well, these nuts, 2016.
Speaking of things going back to their roots and reboots.
These nuts?
These nuts. No, Quake.
Yeah.
Quake Champions.
Ooh, good.
I am the butter in the fridge.
You know what I'm worried about the fact that they're going to do? Because I haven't seen any super new footage on it. I haven't seen anything since, I think, August. But I'm worried that they're going to try and go shooter on it.
I know, because they've got, they talked about...
Huh?
Can we mute Ian for a while?
Can we? I don't...
Hey, you started this! Who said that I will say everything in all caps?
That was Justin.
It was the worst prediction ever.
That was Justin. Oh, God.
We can stop me.
Justin's camera froze. Right.
That's fine.
No, right. It's not fine.
All caps thing anymore.
I mean,
sorry,
you're
guys.
Smiling again, so it's fine, but, it's also not fine.
Yeah.
There we go.
To be worse than trolls.
There we go. Now it's unfrozen. I fixed it.
Yeah, I definitely... The best thing about arena shooters is everyone's on even ground, and there's not a difference from character to character.
Well, I'm worried that they're going to go a different way with that, because if you've watched the trailers, there's special abilities in it. And so is it going to be like each character has their own special ability all of a sudden? Or...
I have that same concern, because that seems like what it's going to be.
I fucking hope not.
Characters they showcased. If they do go that route, I hope there's like a vanilla version of multiplayer that we can play
without powers.
Yeah, because it could be okay, because that can work.
Like hero shooters and they work fine, but I don't want Quake to be a hero shooter.
Did they say Quake requires a monitor, or is Keegan thinking of a different game?
144 hertz monitor. I don't know. I didn't. Hear about it.
I haven't heard about that. It might.
Jedi Ginger and Living Jesus. What can I say? Come as a combo deal.
Oh, Jodo, you haven't met the cast. So yeah, Living Jesus is Justin, and Jedi Ginger is Ian. They're two of my lifelong best friends and my co-hosts for the podcast. We have another co-host who will join us in about a month, when he gets home from Kuwait. So. That's the other members of the Our Life in Pixels podcast.
Ta-da!
Ta-da! It got so quiet there.
Hi, Joda Man.
Anyway, did you play? Did anybody play Enemy Territories?
I don't think I did.
I made the mistake of buying it, and it was like they went so far away from Quake. Like I played every Quake game. Okay, 1, 2, 3, I played the 2. Whatever fucking shit it was. Enemy Territories was a piece of shit game because it was Battlefield but Quake. Like, you could play as either side in the war. And there were different classes with different abilities. There was the medic, there was the engineer, there was the assault, and it was just fucking It was Battlefield Quake, and it was awful. It was terrible.
Class-based.
It was class-based, and dude. I don't mind a class-based game, but Quake. Quake one, you fought the boss. A lava pit and had to trap him with lasers. Correct. Was that one or was that two?
Beats me, man. I just remember the multiplayer.
I remember playing the multiplayer with you.
In my house. Separate rooms.
In separate rooms. That was fun. Yep. But yeah, so I think... I mean, like, do we think that arena shooters are still actually viable? Because I've heard a lot of people did not like the Doom multiplayer.
Really?
Yeah, like... I enjoyed it. I thought it was fun, but like a lot of people were like, it's not what I expected. I'm like, it's an arena shooter. Fuck did you expect? But yeah. There hasn't been a new Unreal Tournament game in forever, even though Unreal keeps coming out with the
Unreal
new engine.
Unreal needs to come back. I want to play so hard.
Yeah, I still play Unreal Black.
Racist.
Yeah, I think there's definitely a place for arena shooters, and I've talked to a lot of people who play, you know, a lot of FPS games, and a lot of them feel like there's something like that missing. Like, I feel like old school Halo kind of had the arena shooter feel. You had the weapon pickups.
I can see that.
You didn't have loadouts. It wasn't class-based. And that's something I liked about SWAT, playing SWAT in Halo. You know, it was just that you versus the enemy, know the map, know the respawns. It's a different kind of skill set in an arena shooter than a standard FPS.
Yeah, I completely agree with that, but because, like, you have to get good at... I mean, you have to... Because most of these games, most arena shooters are kite games in the fucking single player, right? It's a kite shooter in the single player, and then you go in the arena into the arena, you play multiplayer, and all of a sudden everyone's kiting all over the fucking place, and it's crazy, which makes them unique, but, like, in today's world where Call of Duty and Battlefield are two of the top-selling franchises of all time... do we think that these games can still compete, or are you think generally speaking people don't want that? Like, I almost feel like we're slowly moving back towards that, but
right with like Doom and that coming in like a fucking wrecking ball, and people it's kind of like a reawakening of like, oh yeah, before all this bullshit it was fun to just kill things and run around.
Yeah,
it's hard to say, because, I mean, maybe it is the complexity that keeps multiplayer shooters fun for people, but doing away with the grind of, like, having to level up to unlock what you want to use to play, I think that's the way to go.
You think so?
For sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, like arena shooters, love them, so much fun, especially online, obviously, but as long as you have that, you know, you can keep unlocking things, the thrill is still there.
Is it though?
The other question I have for Quake though is really the big one for me, because Quake, other than in enemy territories, Quake always had a badass campaign that was a ton of fun to play, right? And Doom did an extremely good single player campaign, but the new Quake game, just from what I've seen, I've only seen multiplayer in the trailers.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. It looks like it's going to be multiplayer only so far.
It kind of reminds me of Unreal Tournament 2004.
Yeah, it's got that vibe.
Or not 2004. What's the one I'm thinking of? Unreal Tournament Black, not 2004. I'm thinking of Black.
Sure.
Like, that's the one that it makes me think of. So, like, is there a risk of losing out on that amazing badass campaign, or because it's Bethesda and because they just did Doom, do you think they're going to throw that in there?
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like it's hard to say, because you've got a lot of strong just single, like, multiplayer only games coming out, and it might be kind of risky to do the whole campaign multiplayer combo pack. It might be easier to go multiplayer only. Like,
it would be
in regards to finances.
You got a lot of people like me who also love the campaign.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be extremely disappointed if they don't have a Doom campaign.
Yeah. I mean, Bethesda, right? they always do these great single player stories, and I think that that's really what the majority of people want when they get a new game, is like something that they can experience on an individual level. So like, yeah. Cody was talking about how Overwatch could never be game of the year for him because it's a multiplayer only game. And I think that's a pretty common kind of opinion.
Yeah, I mean, I don't completely agree with that opinion, but I think that's probably a pretty common opinion. I think an online-only game done well, like, if it's really expansive, I would agree. I don't think Overwatch... I'm not disagreeing with his take on Overwatch, but still, I don't know. It's hard in these streets for a Jedi, that's right. Oh, by the way, for those who don't know, in chat... Justin is Mr. Farinox, Ian is Red Wonder Bread, so if you got something to tell them, you tell them in chat. Because they'll read
it.
Yeah, don't make me talk to them. I don't like them. Who are these people?
Jeez.
You own Fallout 4 but haven't played it, Ian? God damn it. You told me that last week. Yeah.
Hey, quick question, guys. Quick question. If you put lube on your lips, does it work like chapstick?
I don't believe so, no. Lube?
Lube,
as in like lube. Yeah. Behind. Okay. No, I don't believe so. No.
Water-based lube.
I don't think it works like chapstick. No.
Okay.
Chapstick moisturizes.
I mean, if you were to put lube on your lips, I would assume that.
Let's go. Let's do this.
This is a good blog opportunity for you, Ian.
Oh Jesus! Yeah, Ian, you should try it. You should try it and write a blog about your experience for work.
You should do that instead of playing Fallout 4.
I will say when I said I plan on it, that is chapstick. When I said I plan on it, I meant playing Fallout 4, not actually putting lube water-based on my lips.
Well, I hope you plan on doing that too now.
Where did you get this? How old?
Once he gets the
webcam. I don't know. Frog here. What is it?
It's vanilla cocoa balm.
I don't
Badger, vanilla bean, cocoa
bomb. Badger?
I don't know if that's mine.
But not mine.
It's
not mine either.
I don't buy chapstick.
Alright, when you go to get gas in there.
Yeah, I'll pick up.
If you get an oil how do you know, Joda?
Oh, Joda's a man of many talents.
If you get an oil based, it just stays there as a paste on your lips. That's
or wherever.
It'll soak in.
Cosmetic science.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Joda, I was wondering. I asked you that, but the delay will mean that you're just hearing my question right about now, even though you'll hear this question in about 20 seconds. So,
I mean, yes,
by the way, Sniper, hi. I did see you come in, but I kind of missed saying hi, because I'm a dum-dum.
You're not a sniper.
I'm not a sniper.
Hi.
No. Hi.
Hello. All
right. Side note, Tim, when are you coming up? Because I want Logan's clothes to fit him when he finally gets them.
Yeah, I would love that too. I have no idea when I'm coming up.
Your nails are already painted.
Tears and spit, evolutionary lube. Oh, Arky, this is why I love you.
Hello, Red Wife. Joda says hi.
Hello.
I use the blood of my enemies, Ian. No, you use lube. for your lips.
No!
Oh,
Mama!
I thought she was yelling at me for saying that.
Yeah, she was. Hello.
Oh, perfect. So, we got anything else, guys?
Oh, no.
Closing
we
thoughts. We did.
Apparently, I didn't read the last topic that you sent because I'm like, why did he randomly bring up Quake?
Oh, yeah, no, it's in there.
Oh, yeah, that's number 6 here on our talking
list. Yeah, that's number 6. I was hoping that each of them would last about 10 minutes, but I think the only one that lasted a long time was mobile gaming, and that lasted like 15 minutes.
And half of that was Ian potty training himself.
Half of that was Ian potty training himself.
Oh, yeah, well, I said my piece about mobile gaming and handheld. All
right, well, what do we got for ideas for next week, guys?
Next week? I don't know.
Float something.
Whatever you want.
Better lube for lips.
Better lube for lips. All right, we'll look for better lube for lips that's not lube.
Yes. Better lube for lips of future virgins.
That'll be
for future virgins.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh yeah, the Switch event on the 13th, right?
God, I love Keith and his smartness.
Yes.
ARRPGs. I Into the new ARRPGs. I don't know.
Thursday night? Nice. Yeah, we should definitely talk about the Switch, because that's going to be...
Especially huge. Because that's the same night. Oh, no, because we got to plan out. Guys, I want to let everybody in chat know that the Our Life in Pixels podcast is going to be moved to a different night and possibly a different time. We got to kind of plan it out and sort it out. We got to accommodate some things. So we're going to be... Which new action RPGs are you talking about, though, Joda? Because, like, there's so many of them.
Final Fantasy 15.
I haven't played a Final Fantasy game since, like, I don't know, they were still in single digits.
Ooh.
Been a long time.
Too long.
And that was, I never finished that game because it wasn't my game. I played it at somebody's house.
Sorry, my daughter keeps screaming from the...
Action RPG like Horizon Zero Dawn, will that be considered a new action RPG?
You know what? We should talk about Horizon Zero Dawn next week because that looks amazing.
Robo
we also, and I know Cody will... Grim Dawn just released? I thought that's been out for a while. I thought that was out on Steam for a long time. Anyway, Cody will be jealous about not being in on this conversation because I want to talk about Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands or whatever it's called.
That looks sweet. That looks super fun.
Is it Wildlands? Is that what it's called?
I think so. Keegan, you savage. Oh.
Ghost Recon.
The game was so funny, but the combat of that
Wildlands.
Mario.
I sure like Ghost Paper Recon. Mario. Yeah, I think so too. I think those are two things that we should talk about next week.
Yeah. All right. Definitely.
All right.
Depending on what day we do, so we're switching the day entirely.
Thursdays don't work for Justin and Andrea. So.
Yeah, for the time being.
So we'll figure something out, but we'll figure it out in the group chat on Facebook.
Yeah.
All right, boys. So I'm gonna wrap up then.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Oh, that's adorable.
Bye-bye.
All right, guys. Well,
bye, Bella.
We here at Our Life of Pixels. Bye, we want to thank you guys so much for watching. We want to really thank you guys for the support. Babies. We want to have more red babies, and we will see you guys next time. I will be back in a few hours for my stream at probably around like 1:30 a.m. So that'll be 1:30 a.m. CST. I don't know where you guys are in the world. But for me, it'll be 1:30 a.m. So, yeah. Oh, it's all good, Joda. It's all good, dude. Bow chicka wow wow. All right, that's guys. Go ahead and mute the Skype. Bye. Bye, guys. I will see y'all later. Would have caught the start. Joda, we have a Facebook page and a Twitter account. So if you follow us on Twitter, it's just Our Life in Pixels. I'll post when we figure out what day it's going to be and what time it's going to be from here on out. It has been for the first 5 episodes, Thursdays at 10 CST, but it's going to change. So, yeah. See you guys. Bye!